So, a very good evening to all of you. I welcome you all to the session. Loud and clear. A very good evening to all of you. So today we will discuss some new MCQs, which will be a sort of horizontally integrated MCQs. Means the integration will be along the second year subjects. Horizontal integration means integration along second year subjects. Vertical integration means integration across different phases of your MBBS curriculum. So those sessions will be next week. So before starting the session, a quick review of Unacademy Neet PG segment. With every plus subscription, you get daily live classes, structured courses, live tests, and unlimited access to the entire course structure, both the live sessions as well as the recorded sessions. Then you can avail the benefits of Iconic subscription. And these are the Neet PG and next free tests, which are going to be held on 7th, 14th, 21st, and 28th of March. And similarly, FMG tests are also going to be held on 12th and 26th of March. Then there is a system-wise clinical rapid revision batch course, which has started on 8th of March to be continued till 11th of April. To avail all the benefits, download the Unacademy Learning app from Play Store. Go to Neet PG segment. Select the duration of your subscription. The recommended one is 1 year. You can select which type of subscription you want, whether plus or iconic. Apply this referral code to get a 10% discount at checkout and done. So all of you are ready. Today the length of questions will be more. So I'll be giving you ample time to read the questions. So first question for you all. Read the question carefully and put in your answers in the live chat window. A very good evening to all of you. I welcome you all to the session. Batao, answer batao. Apply all your knowledge. This is what is integrated MCQs mean. Don't go by the length of the question. Length of the question doesn't make a question tough or simple. This word means obtended word, means lethargic. Lethargic. The child has become lethargic. Usually children are sporty, but this child has become lethargic. So simple question, simple answer. A 5-year-old child was admitted to the hospital after ingesting some pills. So there is history of some drug intake. Because of that drug, what happened was, rapidly the child had very high levels of these liver enzymes. Overall, the respiratory system and cardiac system was normal. So, which drug can be ruled out? If your respiratory depression is not there, cardiac depression is not there, you can easily rule out this drug. Opioid group of drugs can be easily ruled out. Then there is no history of any anaphylactic reactions. So, penicillin can also be easily ruled out. Now, the question is between aspirin and acetaminophen. So acetaminophen is basically your paracetamol tablets, PCM tablets, which is usually present in households. And PCM is known to damage your liver necrosis. So that is why the best answer of choice will be yes, acetaminophen toxicity. Yes, all of you are correct. Now, what is AST basically? AST is basically your SGOT, previously called as SGOT. What is ALT? ALT is your SGPT. These are the old names. What is the normal level of these enzymes? Normal level of SGOT is 5 to 40 units. and see the rise here, 850. SGPT normal level is almost 7 to 55 or 56 units. So ALT is also raised a lot. Okay. So remember the normal levels also. SGOT normal level is 5 to 40. SGPT is 7 to 56. Now, which of the following drugs was ingested? Answer is acetaminophen. Now, as a doctor, how will you treat the case? Which antidote you can use to treat paracetamol toxicity? Antidote. Answer. Which antidote you will use? Very good. N-acetylcysteine. So what is so special about N-acetylcysteine? So basically you should always remember this flowchart in your mind. This is your acetaminophen, and what happens regarding its metabolism? About 95% of your paracetamol is detoxified by your phase 2 enzymes, which involve in genobiotics metabolism, and finally they are excreted in urine as glucuronate or sulfate conjugates. So usually there is no toxicity, but when the dose is too large, now this pathway becomes active. Why? Because your cytochrome 2E1 activity, when it increases, it gives rise to production of this unique compound in our body. What is the full form of this one? NAPQ. What is the full form of NAPQ? Anyone? N-acetyl para-benzo-quinone-imine. Quinone-imine. So when this secondary pathway is activated, now your NAPQ is getting formulated, and now this NAPQ is conjugated with your glutathione stores, and our body has got ideal level of glutathione stores. But when more and more of this metabolite is getting formed, now this is deleterious for our body. It leads to hepatocyte necrosis and liver failure, and that was the cause of those rise of liver enzymes in the person. Okay, so remember this pathway of acetaminophen toxicity, and that is why N-acetylcysteine is beneficial. N-acetylcysteine is used as an antidote because it increases the glutathione stores. It helps in enrichment of glutathione stores in the body so that this further damage is prevented. Okay. So this was your first question. Now come to next one. Read the question carefully. And this one is a sort of repeat question from your AIIMS exam. Few things have been taken from one of the repeats of AIIMS exams, and then I have formulated the question. So length of the question doesn't make a question tough. This is the whole idea of these sessions, to help you understand that nothing is going to change. If you have read properly a topic, you will answer any question. So correct answer of this question will be, let us see the lines of the question. A 23-year-old woman is delivered, stillborn fetus was delivered. At about 36 weeks of gestation, the woman experienced sudden onset of lower abdominal pain. Several hours after delivery, an abdominal USG showed a large retroplacental hemorrhage, suggestive of bleeding. सजेस्टिव ऑफ प्लेसेंटल एब्रेशन, प्लेसेंटल एब्रप्शन, एंड दिस इज सजेस्टिव ऑफ स्पॉन्टेनियस अबॉर्शन. So the findings were given in the question as spontaneous abortion has occurred in a female due to placental abruption and she is bleeding profusely. And after that spontaneous abortion, 200 ml of blood loss occurred. Maternal use of which of the following agents is most likely to be associated with these findings? The correct answer will be yes, cocaine. Why cocaine? Because cocaine is the only local anesthetic which is vasoconstrictive. This is a vasoconstrictive agent. So it will constrict your uterine artery supply to the fetus. The fetus will go into hypoxic condition and finally will die. And the spontaneous abortions can occur due to that vasoconstrictive nature of this cocaine. Okay. In addition, always remember, this cocaine has vasoconstrictive activity. So in the female itself, the pregnant female, this can give rise to acute coronary spasms. This was your AIIMS question. A person is presenting with acute coronary spasms. Some ECG findings were given and then it was asked which poisoning you will suspect. So yes, cocaine is one poison which is vasoconstrictive in nature and can lead to acute coronary spasms. Acute myocardial infarction can occur. Okay. Now, if I ask you another thing, what will be the condition of the body, temperature of the body? Hyperpyrexia hoga ya temperature down rahega? What will be the condition of the female? She will be under fever condition, hyperpyrexic condition, or it will be the body temperature will be normal? Nahi, normal nahi hoga. Always remember, cocaine leads to hyperpyrexia. Hyperpyrexia. Your body temperature increases a lot. So this is another important clinching feature to diagnose cocaine poisoning. Hyperpyrexia and seizures are very common. क्योंकि जितने भी आपके biogenic amines होते हैं, cocaine inhibits the reuptake of your dopamine, all the biogenic amines, reuptake is inhibited. So more and more profound effects of all the neurotransmitters are seen, leading to hyperpyrexic feature, seizure activity. ठीक है? Hypo नहीं होता, hyper होता है, hyper. Now, if I show you this image and I ask you that this is a plant called erythroxylon cocoa. Erythroxylon cocoa. From which part of this plant cocaine is obtained? Options are fruits, leaves, stem or roots. From which part cocaine is obtained? This is the plant from which cocaine is obtained. From which part? So always remember, leaves of this plant gives us that product called cocaine, which is a narcotic substance. Legally speaking, this is a narcotic drug. Yes. Not fruits. Always remember, this can be one of the questions. From which part of this plant? And this is a image which came in your AIIMS exam as an image-based question. So, kaise karte cocaine obtained? When the cocaine is obtained, when the leaves are taken, now these leaves are treated with sulfuric acid, H2SO4. What will be obtained is cocaine sulfate. Cocaine sulfate is obtained. Now this cocaine sulfate is further treated with hydrochloric acid. And now what is obtained is the abusive form of cocaine called cocaine hydrochloride. Cocaine hydrochloride. Now this cocaine hydrochloride can be inhaled or it can be injected. It can be taken through different routes of intake are there, like inhalational route, injection route. What about smoking route? This cocaine hydrochloride is unstable when smoking means the thing will burn. So to make it stable, now it is treated with baking soda. So when this cocaine hydrochloride is treated with baking soda, then you create the smoking form of cocaine. Smoking form of cocaine is the most toxic form, and this form is called as, what is the name given to the smoking form of cocaine? What is the name given to smoking form of cocaine? This is called as crack. Huh, opium poisoning will also lead to your opium poisoning will lead to cardiorespiratory depression in that question, previous question. Okay. Smoking form is called as crack. So what are the different routes of intake? Let us simplify this cocaine once and for all. This cocaine can be taken through snorting route. This is one route, inhalational route. So when it is taken through nasal route, it can lead to nasal septum perforation. One of the questions, which poisoning can lead to nasal septum perforation? Answer was cocaine. Which samples you will preserve? You can preserve nasal swabs. That is why nasal swabs are preserved in cocaine poisoning. Then it can be taken through smoking form. Smoking form, you know how it is prepared now. This is called as crack. This is the most toxic preparation of cocaine. Most toxic preparation. Then it can be taken through injection route, through IV route. And usually this cocaine is mixed with which other substance? Through IV route, it is mixed with heroin. And what is that combination called? IV cocaine and heroin combination? A repeat question. क्या बोलते हैं इसको? स्पीड बॉल. दिस इज कॉल्ड स्पीड बॉल. व्हाट हैपेंस इन क्रॉनिक कोकेन अब्यूजर्स? रीसेंट ऑल इंडिया 2020 क्वेश्चन. क्रॉनिक कोकेन अब्यूजर्स दे हैव अ पिक्यूलियर टाइप ऑफ टैक्टाइल हेल्यूसिनेशन. पिक्यूलियर टाइप ऑफ टैक्टाइल हेल्यूसिनेशन एज इफ इंसेक्ट्स आर क्रॉलिंग ओवर द स्किन. व्हाट इज हेल्यूसिनेशन? इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ अ स्टिमुलस there is a false perception. So what is the perception to this abuser? That insects are crawling over his skin. There are no insects, but he is having a false perception. This is also called as formication symptoms or Magnan symptoms. Or Magnan symptoms. As if insects are crawling over skin. ये वाला आपका क्वेश्चन था ऑल इंडिया 2020 का. मैग्नन सिम्टम्स is associated with which poisoning? Answer was cocaine. Now, how will you diagnose a case of cocaine poisoning? How will you diagnose a case of cocaine poisoning? What are the tests used for diagnosis? How will you diagnose a case of cocaine poisoning? So, always remember, this cocaine is metabolized in the body, and one of the metabolites is benzoyl eggonin. Benzoyl eggonin. This is an inactive metabolite, but it can be detected by our tests along with cocaine. This is one of the metabolites. And this cocaine and benzoyl eggonin can be detected in samples like your blood, urine sample, hair sample also. So from these samples, which tests will you use? We can use tests like gold chloride test. This is a microscopic test. Another microscopic test is Scott test. So what you do in gold chloride test? We take a glass slide, we add our suspected sample, and from outside we add gold chloride reagent. Then we will put a cover slip and we will watch under microscope. So what will be the picture under microscope? You will get this picture. A central filament to which is attached perpendicular plates like this. Everywhere you will see a central filament to which is attached perpendicular plates like this. ठीक है, गोल्ड क्लोराइड येलो कलर का रिएजेंट है, So the crystals will be yellow colored or golden colored. So you can get this crystal as a separate question. This is the microscopic picture on testing one of the poisoning agents. Which poison you will suspect? Answer will go with cocaine. Okay. This is the result of gold chloride test. This image we have seen already. So these are some important details about cocaine poisoning. And remember that vasoconstrictive nature of cocaine. What about this poison? Identify this. कौन सा पॉइजन? What about this poison? This is cannabis. What are the products obtained from cannabis? BCG, भांग, चरस एंड गांजा. कुछ लोग मैरिजुआना बोल रहे थे ना उसको. मैरिजुआना इज द स्मोकिंग फॉर्म ऑफ गांजा. दैट इज कॉल्ड मैरिजुआना और मैरी जोन्स. चरस इज ऑल्सो रेफर टू एज हशीश. And bhang is obtained from the dry leaves, and we prepare a sweet from the bhang called mazoon. So these are the different preparations from cannabis. What is this poison? Which cultivation is being done? Which thing is being cultivated? Which thing is being cultivated? This is poppy plant. Scientific name is Papaver somniferum. And from this plant, what is obtained is opium. From which part of the plant? Unripe capsule. This is the unripe capsule. And this is your poppy, which is being extracted by giving cuts over the unripe capsule of this poppy plant. So basically, what is the list of your narcotic drugs? Narcotic drugs. Let us compile. This consists of cocaine, which we just covered, then your cannabis, then your opium. What is the fourth thing which is classified as narcotic drug? Anyone? Fourth thing which is classified as a narcotic drug. Inke alawa, in teen ke alawa, opium is obtained from the poppy plant. Now, after the opium is extracted, what will remain is the dry husk. That dry husk is referred to as poppy straw. Even that is considered to be narcotic. Nahi, LSD narcotic nahi hai. LSD is not narcotic. That will come under psychotropic substance. These are your four narcotic drugs. Cocaine, cannabis, opium and poppy straw. Answer this question. Read the lines of the question. काफी छोटा question है. हाँ, alcohol and nicotine are not narcotic. Remember that. बहुत छोटा question है. आराम से पढ़ लो. Giving you full time. आएंगे ऐसे क्वेश्चंस आपके एग्जाम में. सो बी प्रिपेयर्ड. आई एम मेकिंग अ रिहर्सल फॉर यू ऑल. द होल आइडिया इज क्वेश्चन टफ नहीं होता है. द होल आइडिया इज क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम सिंपल टॉपिक्स. काफी कहानी लिखी हुई है. कहानी का जिस्ट लास्ट में. व्हाट? हाँ, वेरी गुड वेरी गुड. सो लेट मी रीड द क्वेश्चन. अ पर्सन इज हैविंग लोअर लेग स्वेलिंग. ठीक है, एक ये फाइंडिंग दी हुई है. फॉर द पास्ट 6 मंथ्स डिफिकल्टी इन ब्रीदिंग है. समझ आ गया. ठीक है, फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन रिजल्ट इज ऑलमोस्ट ओके टाइप्स, बट हाँ देयर इज बाइलेटरल क्रैकलिंग साउंड ऑडिबल एट लंग बेसिस, दिस इज वन फाइंडिंग. लिवर बढ़ा हुआ है, लिवर स्प्लाइन स्पैन इज इंक्रीज्ड, मींस हिपैटोमेगेली है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फाइंडिंग. इडिमा रहेगा ही क्योंकि स्वेलिंग है तो इडिमा था, ठीक है. लैब फाइंडिंग्स दिए हुए हैं, लीव दैट. पर्सन को एक साल के बाद अक्यूट साइकोसिस हो गया, दिस इज अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फाइंडिंग. एंड ही डाइज ऑफ एस्पायरेशन निमोनिया. वॉट इज द ऑटोप्सी फाइंडिंग? एट ऑटोप्सी यू आर गेटिंग necrosis of ventricles like third ventricle and fourth ventricle, pedicle hemorrhages of grey matter, discoloration bhi ho gaya and hemorrhages bhi hai. And ye wala finding bahut important hai, shrunken mammillary bodies. This is a very important histopath finding of which disorder? Wernicke's encephalopathy and Korsakoff's psychosis. The person has developed psychotic features also. So, chronic deficiency of which of the following vitamins is most likely? Yes, B1. B1 is your thiamine. Deficiency of thiamine leads to Wernicke's encephalopathy as well as Korsakoff's psychosis. So, the person initially presented with encephalopathic features and then he is presenting with that Korsakoff's psychosis also. Korsakoff psychosis. In these two situations, what happens in the brain matter? Mammillary bodies, they shrink. Okay. So the best answer of choice comes out to be B1. Other options ko rule out kaise karenge? How will you rule out? B2 kya hota hai? Riboflavin. Aur aapne padha hoga riboflavin deficiency mein kya hota hai? Wo ek bolta hai chiliosis. What occurs is chiliosis and glossitis. So aise koi features to question mein diye nahi the. Features of chiliosis and glossitis. So riboflavin is ruled out. Now come to this B3. What is B3? This is niacin. Niacin leads to pellagra-like symptoms. So pellagra ke bhi symptoms nahi hai yahan par. So this is also ruled out. B12 leads to megaloblastic anemic picture. Yahan par MCV to utna bada hua hai nahi. So megaloblastic picture bhi nahi hai. So this is also easily ruled out. Niacin is a medicinal drug used for whenever you want to increase your HDL levels. Niacin is a useful drug and it lowers your LDL levels. Okay. So by ruling out also you will reach your correct answer. So remember this autopsy picture of B1 deficiency. Now answer this one. Which of the following is false about snake bite management? Which of the following is false about snake bite management? Put in your correct answers. Very good. So correct answer to the question is correct answer to the question is option D. Neostigmine and atropine is never given for confirmed crath bites because crath venom acts presynaptically act karta hai. So there is no role of giving a thing which is going to act over postsynaptic area. And this is your recent AIMS repeat. What about other options? ASV is the mainstay of treatment. Yes, this is the correct thing. Humped pit viper is not included. Yes, pitless vipers are included in the polyvalent ASV present in India. Pitless vipers are your Russell's Viper and Soy-Scaled Viper. These are pitless vipers. Then neostigmine should be given to the, yes, neostigmine can be given, ventilatory support can be given to be patient along with ASV. This is also correct, but not in crab bites. Neostigmine and atropin can be used for which bites? Which neurotoxic bites? Answer goes with cobra bites. Cobra venom acts postsynaptically. Okay? Clear? Chale aage. Answer this one. Last question for today. A repeat AIIMS question, repeat All India question. This was repeated 2 times in your AIIMS exam itself. What will be your, this is your option A, B, C, D to be marked. A, B, C, D is to be marked. What you will do as a doctor? So what is the valid age of consent for examination purpose? If we talk about general physical examination, what is the age of consent? Is 12 years? A person more than 12 years? A person more than 12 years can give valid consent for general physical examination. So here the female was 14 year old. Yes, her consent is valid. She is complaining of penovaginal penetration by the neighbor. So first tell me, before going to the answer, what is this offense according to POCSO Act? According to POCSO Act, what is this offense? Because the victim is a child, she is less than 18 year old, POCSO Act will come into play. So according to POCSO Act, what is this offense actually called as? Aggravated to hoga. और साथ में aggravated because it is done by a person in authority. Neighbors are persons in authority. They are known faces. So the offense becomes aggravated and this is referred to as aggravated penetrative sexual assault under POCSO Act. Penetrative sexual assault. So in such cases, what should be your role? If the patient is refusing consent for examination, first of all, always remember in such scenarios, you have to call the policeman. So yes, this option is correct. You have to inform the policeman. If the victim is not consenting, you cannot touch the victim for examination purpose. So what you will do next? You will counsel the mother and daughter. You will do a psychological counseling. That behan tayar ho jao. Even then, if they are not agreeing, now take an informed refusal, which can be done, which has to be taken in a written format. Take their signature for your own safety. So that is why option A will be the best answer. 2, 3, 5 will, is the true statement. Correct? Chalo, that's all for today. Hope the session was interesting. So next week we will have sessions related to vertical integrated questions, some lengthy questions which will have vertical integration, means integration with all other year subjects other than second years. Tomorrow I will have classes, I will prepare the classes on Unacademy app. The free sessions on Unacademy app will be there from 9:30 to 10 p.m. in the night. And this one will cover all your toxicology MCQs. So it will be a sort of quiz for you all, live quiz. Daily we will try to cover 15 to 20 MCQs pertaining to different topics of toxicology only. So this will continue. Tomorrow is I think 15th, no? 15th, 16th, 17th and 18th March. Till 18th it will continue. And the further upcoming YouTube live sessions will be on next weekend. Next Saturday and Sunday, that is 20th and 21st March. Same timing in the evening, 7 to 7:30. This is a special class on Unacademy app. This is a toxicology quiz which any student can join. Links I will share in my Telegram group shortly. By midnight, I will share the link. It will be pinned in the Telegram group itself. Chalo then, bye-bye. Maintain your safety and health and keep your confidence on the rise. हाँ वीकेंड तो हो गया ना, तो संडे हो गया, खत्म हो गया. थैंक यू डेफिनेट सिंह, थैंक यू.